Hello, Secretary, and to your team. I'm glad you're here today, and I have a few questions for you. One is about the Women's Health Services Program. With the new Women's Health Services Program in place, it provides important reproductive health care across six regions. How do these services incorporate maternal health care, especially in some of our most rural counties in our Commonwealth?
Yes, well, thank you, Representative, for that question. And we're enthusiastic about our new women's health programs. We very deliberately, with this opportunity, created regions across the Commonwealth because we all know that the circumstances are very different in different regions of the state. We've already today talked about how variable the access is to certain services across the state. And so we did want to make sure that local folks could really prioritize their local needs. And as part of this program, there are a number of required deliverables that our grantees must provide or deliver upon. There are prenatal care and postpartum supports, early detection and prevention of health conditions, parenting, education programs, menstrual and reproductive health education and menstrual products as needed, sexually transmitted infection testing and care or referrals if they can't do the care themselves, and then referrals for assistance with other physical and behavioral health care needs. So it's a very comprehensive approach. Whether you happen to be pregnant at a moment, all of these services help make sure that you are healthy if you do choose to become pregnant and then have a healthy pregnancy and postpartum period.
Thank you. I'm looking forward to that program really being successful in the Commonwealth. My second question is around doula and community health worker reimbursements. What are the goals for a structured-based program with Medicaid and the managed care organizations to make it transparent and accountable for all involved? I know that through the Medicaid and the maternity care bundles include doulas, right? But what does that plan look like? And how does that, the department plan to partner with the MCOs around navigating patient outcomes? Specific example would be if a patient is only most comfortable working with their doula and really doesn't want to work with the rest of the team, the care bundle, how does everyone stay accountable in the measurements of how these services are rendered to the most importantly lower the staggering maternal mortality and morbidity rates across our Commonwealth?
So we know, and as we've discussed many times, doulas are essential healthcare providers. And for many pregnant women and birthing people, particularly Black women and birthing people, doulas are a provider that they choose over other providers because for a whole variety of reasons. And so we want to make sure that that choice is empowered and supported. I'm going to come back to your first part of your question, but I'm just going to add that just as I recently, a few minutes ago, discussed around community health workers, we are also putting into place a program with the Pennsylvania Doula Association to certify doulas to enable them to become providers within the Medicaid program. And so once that's fully realized, and what we really need is more doulas signing up to be part of this, but our hope is that once we have enough doulas as providers that we can offer statewide coverage of doulas, that we will actually incorporate doulas services into our formal state Medicaid plan. So that's coming. But then in the meantime, we have required our MCOs to respond affirmatively to any patient who wishes to have a doula, assuming there is a doula, you know, somewhere in that area that can provide those services. So to be fully honest, there may not be a doula in a particular place, even though a patient may want one.
Right.
If there is, then our MCOs are required to provide that.
Well, we know, Secretary, particularly in Black maternal health, we know that women, you know, we talk about the Medicaid system, but we know that women are dying at high rates, that their education, their income, all of that is a factor now. And it's impacting women who have higher socioeconomic statuses. So what does the department plan on doing in the private sector around doula care and reimbursements in that way?
You make a very important point. The data is quite clear when it comes to Black maternal mortality that it is not related to income. And it's, you know, we've seen many very prominent examples of that across our country. So I have brought this, raised this issue with Commissioner Humphreys from our insurance commissioner. I don't have the ability to require commercial health insurance plans to cover this service, but I know that is something that he is considering and discussing, and I don't know the current absolute status of that right now, but it's something that I'm sure he would be happy to discuss with you.
I really appreciate your comments today. Thank you, Chairman.
Thank you.